Welcome all of you. So we are going to start with our first lesson, that is geometrical figures from standard 4th. So what are geometrical figures? Now geometry means what? Geometry is the branch or it is a study of mathematics which is based on shapes, line segment, angles, etc. For you right now there are few basic concepts. So we are just going to study. So first concept is angles. So what are angles? Angles means whenever you see two lines intersecting or two lines meeting each other, whatever thing is formed is said to be an angle. So angles are basically termed into three main types. There are more types, but that will be there for your higher education. Right now for fourth standard only there are three types, that are acute angle, right angle and obtuse angle. I am repeating again, acute angle, right angle and obtuse angle. One thing you should remember, angle is measured in terms of degree. Degree means it is being denoted in a small O type. For example, if an angle is of 45 degree, you are supposed to write degree on the index. You are going to write degree, this symbol, over the top of it. So first we will study, that is acute angle. So what is acute angle? You are knowing a crocodile opening his mouth. So the shape you can see of it, or you can see the tree. So these are the branches of it. So whatever angle you can see over here, for example, this is a tree. You can see the branches form over here. So this angle which you can see over here, the angle in terms of the whole tree, that angle, that particular shape is called as angle. And this is an acute angle. So acute angle means what? In terms of degree, if you ask, it will be less than 90 degree. So what is acute angle? Acute angle is that angle which is less than 90 degree. Now where you can see this acute angle? If you ask me the examples, I can tell you the crocodile opening his mouth. Another example can be, you can see the branches, the angle which is formed there. If the branches are wide, then you can use the word obtuse. So what is obtuse, we will study later. First, what is acute angle? Acute angle means the angle which is less than 90 degree. The next important one is right angle. So what is right angle? Right angle means when it is equal to 90, when if you compare in terms of degrees, it is equal to 90 degrees. Always remember, for denoting right angle, you are supposed to use this symbol. You are not supposed to use this one. It is only used for acute angle and obtuse angle. For right angle specifically, you are going to use this symbol. It is being used for denoting the perpendiculars. Now what is perpendicular? It is not actually for you, so I am not going to disclose also that part. So right angle means what? It is equal to 90 degree. Now you have seen right angle many times. For example, you can see the two edges of your book, two consecutive edges of your book, or two adjacent edges of your book. I'll just show you one. If you see over here, you can see this part and this part. You can see the 90 degree forming over here. Okay, you can see the scale also which is present in my hand. You can see this edge and you can see this edge. So whatever the angle is formed over here, that is called as right angle, which is equal to 90 degree. The next part is obtuse angle. Obtuse angle means what? The angle which measures more than 90 degree is called as obtuse angle. So what is obtuse angle? The angle which is more than 90 is called as obtuse angle. Now we are going to just see or just recognize few angles from here. Can you tell me? Now you should help me out from here. So can you tell me which is this angle? Yes, you can see a symbol over here. Every time we are not going to mention you the symbol. So you should remember, you can see the degree, it is equal to 90 degree. So this is called to be as right angle. Can you tell me which is this angle? Yes, this is one example of acute angle. So this is right angle. This is acute angle. Can you tell me which is this angle? Yes, this is also acute angle. Can you tell me which is this one? Yes, it is obtuse angle. You can see the mouth which is little broad one. Can you tell me which is this one? Yes, this is also acute angle. This part? Yes, this is called as right angle. Can you tell me this one? Now you will be thinking, teacher, this is twisted or it is totally opposite. So just don't worry. You can see the symbol over here and you can easily identify this one. So yes, this is also right angle. So the next part of this lesson is the circle. Now can you tell me, where do you see such figure in your surrounding? Yes, the wheel or the tires. You can see the clock shape also. You can see many things which are in circular shape. For example, the plate which you eat, from which you eat, the same plate is also in the circular way. So this is termed to be as a circle. We are knowing the geometrical figure. This is said to be as circle. So for you right now, they have asked you and they have told you the parts of circle. So what are the parts that we are going to study now? So what is this called as? Yes, this is called to be as the center of circle. It is called to be as center of circle. When you are joining a line passing from the center and which is touching the circle at another side, or which is touching the circle at other part, is said to be as a radius. What is it called as? It is said to be as a radius. Now, is it radius is only one? No, radius can be infinite. It will be many. You cannot count it. I can draw one more radius over here. What is my definition for radius? It should pass through the center. It should go, it should start from the center and it should touch any part of the circle. I can say this is also one radius. I can say this is also one radius. So the line which comes from the center and joins either side, the other side of the circle, is said to be as the radius. So what is this called as? Which passes from the center and which touches both the side of the circle. Again, I am repeating, it should pass from the center and it should touch both sides of the circle. That is called to be as a diameter. And the last part of it is, if you draw a line touching any two points of the circle, it is said to be as a chord. What is it called as? Yes, it is called as a chord. The next part of this we will discuss